Don't really know what to say about this one, FDev, but you definitely screwed the pooch on this one. We're going to start this epic journey at 3 o'clock in the morning Alaska time, right as the beta drops. I'm extremely tired at this point, Commanders, but I have a mission to complete. Going to be the very first fleet carrier to orbit Borann 2. But not with just any fleet carrier, Commanders. I'm going to put my billions to use and fully pimp out everything you can possibly pimp out on the fleet carrier. Here I am at Kepler's Gateway just a few minutes later. It's one of the places you can buy a fleet carrier, and there it is, 5 billion price tag. Kind of feel like I'm leasing this thing and not buying it, but hey, it is what it is. Need to come up with a really cool name for this thing. You guessed it. If you follow any of my videos, Space Cheddar 1 is what it's going to be. Unfortunately, you can't change your carrier ID, which is kind of stupid. Goodbye, 5 billion units. You were such a good friend for so long. Just living in my pocket, doing nothing for me. But now I guess I am the proud owner of a Brewer fleet carrier. As long as I don't lose it due to high upkeep costs, that is. Now that we have a little less than 6 billion left in the bank, let's head over to our fleet carrier and check it out for the very first time. Excitement is completely off the charts at this point, Commanders. Fortunately, it was tainted by 3 loops of shame, considering the clocks were not lining up properly and there was a bug in the very beginning of beta. It was literally that awkward moment when you had to crawl around really slow just so you wouldn't keep doing loops of shame over and over in an endless cycle. Finally landed on Space Cheddar 1. I feel like I'm behind the gun a little bit. Other commanders might be able to beat me there, but I'm still going to blaze ahead for Borann 2 after I get this thing fully and completely pimped out. Whoever designed this feature needs to be fired. It takes forever and ever to add money to your fleet carrier so you can actually add the services to the fleet carrier. And considering if I don't speed this part up, we are going to be here all day long, I'm just going to cut to the chase. Well, that's 2 minutes of my life I'm never going to get back. It literally took 2 minutes to add all those funds. That's crazy. I know what you're thinking, Commanders. A billion units should be plenty to add all these facilities to my fleet carrier, right? Yeah, we'll get to that later. Have to admit, in my rush to get to Borann 2 first, I am not paying attention to any of the upkeep costs on these facilities whatsoever. I'm just stuffing them in there as quick as I can, which is a bad idea. Pay attention to the prices. Blew 860 million like it was nothing in a matter of seconds, and I still do not have enough to add outfitting or secure warehouse, so you guessed it. Time to have fun adding a whole crapload of money to my carrier once again. Here we go with more engaging gameplay of adding money to the fleet carrier, which takes half of your life to do. Alright, now that we got more money in there, let's add outfitting and secure warehouse. Gonna go ahead and snag up this ship pack here so I can have the best of the best of the best, sir. Ended up having to add another billion to the account, which was another 2 minutes out of my life. Added another billion to the bank fund so I can buy more modules for my outfitting services. Gonna snag up some tier 3 cargo racks. I kinda hate having to buy these in packs because there's a lot of things you're not gonna want. Tier 3 mining tools. Is it really necessary to have hundreds of refineries? I guess it is. Snagged up some of the sensors and some collector limpets. Now let's get our ships transferred over here and get the heck over to Borann. Got my ships being transferred over from Jameson Memorial. Definitely gonna get here before we have to leave because of the 1 hour spool up time. I spent the first 15 minutes of my epic, exciting gameplay talking to other commanders in system about how awesome these fleet carriers are and how much we just could not wait to go and experiment with them. Unfortunately, the other 45 minutes of my awesome, epic gameplay involved me going out into the living room, cleaning up out there, and then cleaning up the kitchen just to kill time. So honestly, that 1 hour spool up time's kind of a killer for me. I really hope that they can adjust that. The other minor irritation is, why am I sitting in the belly of my fleet carrier inside of my ship when I could be just staring out the awesome windows in my command center and seeing this all happen first person? But instead, we're just gonna sit here and listen to sound effects for like 15 to 20 seconds. If there's one thing that FDev does exceptionally well in this game, is they know how to make engaging sound effects for sure. I just wish that carried over to other aspects of Elite Dangerous. It is of my humble opinion that the 1 hour spin-up and cooldown times are just far too long. It's just not necessary. And while you're at it, give me a command deck with big giant windows I can look out of. If not, then daggone it, bolt my ship to the outer hull of this thing so I can see myself jump, please. That would be much appreciated. I noticed something a little odd when I was plotting a course to Borann. It is pretty strange that these things have a 500 light year jump range, but they can't do it in just one trip. I had to actually plot waypoints to get there. The other thing that I found a little bit odd was the Borann system was undiscovered to me in beta, and I had been here long before March 26, farming like a mofo, just like everyone else. I didn't understand why I couldn't open up the Borann system, but the brutal realities of that is about to set in here in just a second. Finally, we have arrived in the Borann system, but unfortunately, it sucks because I am at the other star, which is hundreds of thousands of light seconds away from Borann 2. Oh joy. Yeah, looks like there's already a bunch of fleet carriers here. The good news is most of them are trapped at the star over here with me, with the other half of them being over there by the planet near the other star. And sweet, there's only two carriers at the moon around Borann 2, so it looks like I still have a shot to be the first carrier that orbits Borann 2. Let's keep our fingers crossed, commanders. Even though I had to make a second jump from that other crappy star, we ended up being the very, very first fleet carrier to orbit Borann 2, which I'm very proud of, because a lot of commanders tried to be the first. Now that I finally made it here, let's talk about the good and the bad that the fleet carriers brought to Elite Dangerous. The ability to store a lot of your ships on the fleet carrier is a huge plus for me. The commodity markets come stock on every single fleet carrier, which is a win. That is going to be your very, very best bet in making money in this game when these fleet carriers come out. Buy low and sell high, it's pretty much every businessman's wet dream. You have the ability to do commander-to-commander trading via the commodity market, again, which is a big bag of win. The ability to jump you and all your ships at least 500 light-years per jump is actually pretty awesome, although in my opinion I think it should be much more considering the tritium costs and the amount of time it takes to farm tritium. A mobile refueling, repairing, and rearming station is very cool, although if you are an explorer, you're kind of getting the short end of the stick, so let's just start talking about the negatives. First and foremost, as a negative, I believe almost all the commanders are unanimously going to agree that upkeep costs are absolutely outrageous. And we're not talking about just a little bit too expensive, they are outrageous. After the live stream with FDev, they announced a $10 million a week upkeep cost, and that's just for the basic carrier. And everybody, well, I wouldn't say everybody, a lot of commanders lost their minds. And for me, 10 million is literally only 2 minutes of laser mining profits, so it's no big deal. I pimped out my carrier all the way, got my first estimate, and it was only estimating 44 million for upkeep, and I was like, hey, you know, that's actually not super horrible, I can deal with that. Tuh, boy was I wrong. That was actually a 2-day estimate, considering the server reset was only a few days after the beta began, so it was closer to 145 million per week. That is crazy. If you are an explorer, you are getting the short end of the stick on this one. A 500 light year jump range isn't super horrible, but the 2-hour in between jumps is just outrageous. Considering you can make it from the bubble to Colonia in about 1 hour and 45 minutes in a jump Aconda, 56 hours if you want to do it in a fleet carrier. Ken, we're not even going to go into Bugle Point and how long that's going to take. Oh my goodness, that is literally going to be a half a year trip, I would imagine. Stellar cartography is also not included on the fleet carriers, which I can kind of understand in a way, so let me explain. Whenever you sell exploration data, you're actually selling it to the controlling faction in a system, and that information's value is kind of based off of the distance traveled to that system. If you end up selling your exploration data on your own personal fleet carrier, you're basically selling it to yourself. The other thing I would like to see instead would be just to have some kind of personal storage unit on there so you don't lose any of your exploration data if you happen to die. The way fleet carriers are right now, and the way the numbers are panning out, if you want to take this fleet carrier into the black and do a lot of deep space exploration, you are going to need to load billions and billions of credits onto this thing, or you are going to go bankrupt halfway through your trip. FDev is going to need to figure out a way for explorers to earn credits in deep space, or there's going to be a lot of unhappy customers out there. Alright, reselling ships and reselling modules the way it is currently with these having to buy packs of items for the full price, that is no bueno. That is literally a money sink where you are not going to make anything back, commanders, so don't bother quite yet. And really, I could go on and complain a little bit more, commanders, but this is very early beta. I know all these prices are going to change. Let's hope that these spin up and spin down times are going to be fixed. Let's hope that there is some way for explorers to actually make money out in the black. And if they can do that, I'm going to be very happy about these things. I've got two words for you, commanders, and that is the commodity market. Commodity market is going to be where you can possibly earn billions upon billions of units. Take this from somebody that used to run an economy on Guild Wars 2 on an entire server. It is possible, and I can see it happening with fleet carriers here in Elite Dangerous. Think I'm going to end it there, Commanders. What are your feelings on the fleet carriers in the current state right now in beta for Elite Dangerous? I know I kind of have mixed emotions, and a lot of Commanders do as well, so please down in the comments, let me know how you feel, and I will feature your comment in the very next Elite Dangerous video I make. I will pick at least the top 5 that I like the most. So I will catch you in the next videos, Commanders. Peace. 145 million a week? You have got to be kidding me.